Hello, I'm Ilyan St-Hilaire, and in this video, we're going to talk about managing your local devices through MeshCentral without an agent. One often overlooked feature of MeshCentral is the ability to act as a web portal for local devices on your network and do so without any agent installed. Obviously, not having an agent is great because you don't have that software running, and you can still benefit from having MeshCentral acting as your web portal. So let's take a look at how this would be done. So I'm going to start with a few slides here, and I'm going to start by recapping the three modes that MeshCentral has: WAN mode, LAN mode, and hybrid mode. MeshCentral by default starts as LAN mode, where the agents will multicast on the network, find the server, so the server doesn't need to be a fixed IP address. But in LAN mode, one of the interesting points of this mode is that the server can initiate outbound connections to devices. In LAN mode, the server has a well-known DNS name. The agents will use that DNS name to connect back to the server, authenticate it, and then you get the management services. But the server cannot initiate a connection towards an agent. That's because you're in the cloud somewhere like AWS, Google, or Azure, and so you know the agent is probably behind a proxy or a NAT or something, and there's no way for the server to initiate a connection back to the agent. So the agents initiate the connection only in this mode. In hybrid mode, you're kind of in a mix of the two. You have a fixed set DNS name, but you're also capable of initiating connections to local devices on the local network. So this is interesting because let's review the three types of device groups that you can create in MeshCentral. The first one and the most often used one is the agent-based device group. It's available in LAN, WAN, and hybrid. And in that case, you install an agent, and the agent will connect to the server or find the server using multicast and then connect. And that's how you manage a device. There's also an Intel AMT only device group. In that case, Intel AMT can connect back to the server, or the server connects to Intel AMT on the local network. Now, this is only available if you have Intel Active Management technology on your devices and you want to use that feature without installing an agent. The last group, and this is the group we're going to talk about today, is the local device group. In that case, it's only available in LAN and hybrid modes, and the server will initiate a connection to the application. So MeshCentral will initiate a connection to SSH or SCP, FTP, or RDP. And so that's what we're going to see today. Basically, the server will initiate these connections outbound to these devices on the local network. Okay, so I'm going to use my trusty developer machine and developer setup. I have a MeshCentral here running. I'm just running it manually. It is in hybrid mode, so LAN and WAN mode. Now, if you're not running the server manually, you can go in your the website, click on My Server, go on Console, type Info, and you'll see what mode your server is in. Okay, so now I have a bunch of machines here. I can click on one, remote desktop, and that works. But this is all, these are all in the agent group. Let's say I want to manage using local devices without an agent. Well, I'm going to first go at the bottom here, say add device group. I'm going to say test local device group. And I'm going to select local devices, no agent. Now, this option, of course, is only available if the server can do outbound connections. I'm going to say OK. There's my new group. I'm going to set up a new machine here, and I'm going to do that by clicking Add Device, and you're going to have to enter the device name, the host name, and the type of device that this is. So notice that instead of prompting you to download and install an agent, it's just prompting you for the host name of the device and the name and the type. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take like this Raspberry Pi here that has this IP address. And now it already has an agent connected, but for this demo here, I'm going to add it as with this IP address. I'm going to call it RPi, and I'm going to say it's a Linux machine. Say OK. There we go. I have my Raspberry Pi. I can click on it. I can still change the icon, so I'm going to put a Raspberry Pi there. I can change the name if I want to. I have notes and stuff. And I have a terminal and a file tab. Now, if I click on terminal, this is actually SSH. And so you see here at the top right, it says SSH port 22. I can change that if I want to. And when I connect, I can type in my username and password for SSH. And I can authenticate using username and password or username and key if I have a certificate. And then I'm going to say remember credentials. In that case, the server will remember my credentials for this SSH session. So that's good. Now, don't worry about this warning. And then we are connected to this SSH session. I can do ls and so on. So that's super nice. By the way, the SSH terminal does support resizing. So if I type nano, for example, I can resize this. And you can see that the terminal does resize correctly, which is really nice. It's a pretty fancy terminal. Control X, I can type exit, and it disconnects. Okay, so I have SSH onto my local devices, and now I can connect again, and because it remembers the credentials, boom, I'm connected again. And of course, I can grant permissions to that device to other users, and the users will have the credentials that are in the server. Okay, then I can do files. So file here, it uses the same SSH port. This is SCP, and so I can click. I can, for example, I have email.txt here. I can drag and drop it, and there it goes. I can rename, put a 2 there. I can delete. So this is pretty cool. But here, what's going on is that MeshCentral is completely acting as an SCP client and offering the web UI for that SCP client. So MeshCentral server is doing a lot more work here than you would have normally. Normally, the commands from this window goes to the mesh agent. Now they're going to the server, being translated into SCP command and sent to the SSH port. So that's how that works. Okay, and then if you have VNC on that device, you can click VNC there. Another, what I'm gonna do is demonstrate in my AMT15 machine here. I'm gonna grab the IP address and I'm gonna demonstrate a Windows machine. So this is test Windows. Let's say this is RDP. There it goes. So now I have a Windows machine here. I can click on it, say Web-RDP. And by the way, you'll notice that there's no file or terminal tab here because this machine doesn't have SSH on it. But I can click there, type my password. The username is demo in this case. I'll remember the credentials, so the server will remember the credentials. And then if I connect, there you go. I have a RDP session entirely web-based to this computer. So that is very, very cool. And I can disconnect. I think I can disconnect by, there it goes, disconnect there. And then I'm back to the screen there. And of course, it's a separate tab, so I can close the tab anytime I want. Okay, and then by the way, you see here credentials RDP. That's because I told it to remember the credentials and the server's telling me that it remembers the RDP credentials. For Raspberry Pi, I have SSH here, so it remembers the SSH credentials. Okay. So that's about it. I want to do one more point before I leave this, and is that you can use MeshCentral Router on devices that are locally managed, like we just talked about. But normally, MeshCentral Router will go through a mesh agent and then locally to a server or an application here. But if you're doing MeshCentral Router to a device that is locally managed, like we just did now, then the connection will go to MeshCentral, and then MeshCentral will initiate the connection straight to the application on the local network. But otherwise, MeshCentral Router will work with locally managed devices. It's just that the routing is a little different. So I think that's about it. The really nice thing about this mode is that you can manage a lot of devices and you do not need to have an agent installed on any of your computers. Hope that was useful. Thank you very much.